That is noted. That is noted. You know what I forgot to do on my flight plan? I forgot to add passengers. I think I did. Let's see, let me go to Volanta really quick. Yeah, this is the new Tolus 319, the updated with the Hoppy's CP DLC, but there's no ATC online, so we can't really use it. But let me go back here because I need to see if I added passengers on here or not. I don't think I did. Oh, yes, I did. All right, we're good. Blah, e-hell. Yeah, I'm flying a computer plane. Everybody stand back. Don't be scared. All right, I need to find out how I can get rid of the shading here on the screens. I can't remember. Let's see, there's a way to do that. I'm trying to remember how to do it really quick. So I had 100, what was it? How many passengers did I have? Is it gonna tell me here? 109. 109. And then let's see, cargo is 7.8. What do we got here? But what's my zero fuel weight? 109, zero fuel, 122.2. We're close. So we'll put a little bit more right here. Put some more back here. Block fuel is... Block fuel... 12.5. 12.6. It's good to me. Good to me. But there's a way to turn down those. I think there's a way to turn down the reflections. I'm trying to remember how to do it. Engine volume. Not joysticks. It's not that. Screen glow. Here it is. Window reflection, display refractions. There, I can't stand that shit. Baby bus, oh yeah, we're doing the baby bus. We're in the baby bus tonight. San Francisco, Reno, and possibly turning it around here. But we be in the baby bus. All right, so let's get this started here. So we can bring this up. Let's bring this over here. San Francisco. We're going to Mexico Center's hometown. Reno. We're going to Reno. Go ahead and do that like that. Flight number is United 1049. Cost index. 25, I don't know. Cruise altitude's 29,000. Da 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 da. Wind. Request it. Next phase. I gotta remember how to even fly this freaking damn plane. Well, there you go. You're welcome, sir. You're welcome. See, I match with the Amber Alert. All right, let's go departure. Runway 1 right. It's the truck in. No, I gotta go up. Truck in 2. Orca. Insert. Alright, we did that Orca, and then it's going to be the Orca 1. Runway 17 right. Oh wait, run 7 right's closed again. Shit. So I got to do the RNAV runway 17 left. What's the one that comes over Hoboa? This is 12. This is X-Plane 12. Is it X-Ray, Yankee, or Zulu? Let me see. It is... it's not X-Ray. It's not Yankee. So it's Zulu. Yeah, it's Zulu. And we're going to take it from the Orca 1, Hoboa. And we're going to insert. Alright, let's see what we got here. We got tie-dye, Hoboa, Snidit, Jodhpu, Gunnar, whatever that is, Itida, Hogbo, and then runway 17 right. Alright, so that looks correct there. Now I gotta remember what else to do here. Clear that. Clear, you rat bastard. Holy shit, this is bright. Turn that down a little bit. Let's see, those are all in nav. We can turn on the pumps. I feel like I'm missing something. We got 3021. Now we gotta come over here. So this thing has now got the tablet where you can do your, if I can figure out what freaking button I used to do your weight and balance stuff. I've never used it. Right? Direct these big nuts. That's messed up, bro. That stuff's hurtful. 109, 2800, 52. So we're good there, right? 29.3. Say, okay, that's all in there. Runway 1 right. I think this is taking it from the, it's already picking up the weather. So it hit compute. So flaps will be 1, flex temp of 72, V1 109, 136, VR 136, 3 up 0.2, green, I don't know what the hell green dot is. What is that, green dot? That's the speed. Status is okay. Oh, you're good, bro. You're good. I don't even know what the hell I'm doing here, bro. This is the first time we've used this with this new update. So you know you guys are gonna die. Oh man. Oh, you guys. All right, Milo, I gotta remember how to do this, man. McDo, Atsu, AOC menu, initialize the flight. I think is upset the gamer should have been direct big nut. These big nuts. No. This is X-Plane 12. X-Plane 12. Not allowed. I can't get departure radius. Sons of bitches. Or let's see here. San Francisco forecast ATIS. Oh, these don't work yet. What the frick? I can't get that shit yet? Alright, that must be still work in progress then. Alright, let's go second page. Departure clearance, I can't get that, so that doesn't matter. So I guess just the AOC menu. It's not like the FS Labs. ATC menu, that's if we wanted to do that, but we're not going to have to worry about that. There's nobody on anyways. Real men fly Boeing. Come on, don't be hating, bro. Don't be hating. We got to give everything a chance. Got to give it a chance. All right, so this is where we need to come over to the pad again because I can't see shit. So V1, 136. VR, 136. V2 is 138. Transition altitude is 18. Flaps is 1. What is it again? It's flaps 1 and then down. Okay, that's what it is. So it's 1/down. No, it's up. Sorry, it's up. Up. 0.2. No, format area. Maybe it's okay. Flaps/UP.02. Oh, you bastard. UP 0.2. HK Flight Simulation, what's up? Flex temp is 72. Runway, didn't put the runway in there. Runway 01 right. It's not gonna let me put that in there. Let me see what we got going on here. There might be a problem. Yeah, I put it in there. I got it in there now, it works. Up 0.2. Let's see, what's after that? That's the climb mode, 20.78, that's fine, whatever. Next is cruise, don't care about that. I think that's it, right? If I remember that, I mean, that's all we need. Oh, wait a minute, it's like the flight plan's gone. What the hell? Alright, let's try this again. Did I erase something? I don't remember erasing anything. Oh, you know what it did? Is when I requested it, it cleared it out. That's what happened. It cleared it out. I know what I did. I know what happened now. It cleared it out. I remember. So don't do that when you request it. Alright, so that's left. We want Zulu. Orca, Hoboa. All right, let me look at this again really quick. Wait a minute, is that right? Okay, Trucking, Orca, Hoboa, Sandit, Jupiter. Okay, we're good. All right, I think we're done. I don't think there's anything else to do. Max is 39. That's all in there now. That's good there. We're good there. 8.7 is what we're supposed to do. That's good there. Destination, that's the descent. Oh, we gotta do this part. You guys didn't tell me to do this part. Arsh, what's up, dude? KSFO. Okay, we need to put in the QNH. QNH is 3020. Oh, that's approach. What the hell am I doing? I don't do that right now. That's it. We're done. Come on, Miles. You got to be on top of this stuff, bro. You got to be on top of this stuff. I can't do this all on my own. Okay, we're set there. That's good there. Seatbelt signs on. Those are on. What am I looking here? Let's see, data link is on standby. We don't care about data link. That goes up. Let's see here. Can't wait for the stream of race. Still better aggressive. Okay. Alright, I think we're ready. Again, the only thing on is Oakland Center. I mean, not Oakland Center, Los Angeles Center. We're not going to talk to him anyways. So we'll go over here, we'll bring on the beacon light, that's on nav. Strobe doesn't need to be on yet. I'll go ahead and pull the jetway. Move it, move it. Ah, I've been doing good, HK. How you been doing? Or wait, did I bring the gate up here? I might have not brought the gate up here. Oh, I did. Okay, I did. I couldn't remember if I did or didn't. Are you not going to move back? All right, we'll just call for the pushback then. Let's see, nope, other one. Oh, this is a better pushback. Put me right there.
All right, Captain, got the directions. Let me know through the menu when you're ready.
Let's see, X-Ray 12, Kappa. It's been a while. Move it, move it! We got to move it, move it. Okay, so we're good. We'll go ahead and tell them we're ready to push. Damn it, I keep on hitting the wrong one. Not Sam. Better push back.
Great news, Captain. Your tow's coming.
You don't have to be so loud, bro. So 0.2 up. You gotta get to move it, move it. You fired me and I started my holiday 3 hours ago. I never fired you, Miles. That was a misunderstanding. That was a misunderstanding, bro. That was a total misunderstanding. Is this gate not gonna move or what? Gate should be moving. I don't know why it's not moving.
All right. Looks like the doors and hatches are closed and we're ready to connect.
Well, go ahead, buddy, and connect. You can do it. Let's see that all my doors are closed. Door one closed. Just to make sure. Now, I haven't flown an Airbus in forever, so remember, you guys pick the airline, not me. Yes, you are.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Toes connected, bypass pens inserted. Go and kill the parking brake when you're ready to go.
Are you not gonna do it? Parking brake off.
Here comes the pushback. Light them up.
I'm waiting. Look at that, it even has the time up there. What time it is right now. 2018 local. Alright. So we got the ignition, we're turning it. Starting to. The jetway didn't move. That's okay. Engines are spinning. Oh, look at that guy. That guy's dead. What an idiot. Is the music too loud, guys? I can't tell if it's loud or not. Let me see. Turn it down a little bit. It's not, all right. Brian, I'm going to Charlie 5 in Reno. That's a United gate. Charlie 5. Okay. All right, starting one. No, Now, Brian, is this him a piece of shit? This is not a piece of shit, right? Don't hurt my feelings, Brian. No, it's number one. It's the number one sin. Oh, there goes our nose gear. I guess we won't have to worry about the nose gear. Stop any time.
Just about done here. Go ahead and set your parking brake.
Parking brake is set.
And we're disconnecting the tow. Give me just a moment.
Why are you so loud, bro? Alright, what we got here? Nose gear disconnect. Yes, on standby. And we're gonna go ahead and put this into auto. That's on. That'll go over to there. TCAS, we're just gonna throw a freaking squat code in here. We're gonna turn it on. Let's disconnect, go to hand signals. Kiss my ass goodbye. Go ahead and set flaps to 1. There goes our flaps, leading edges.
And we're disconnected. Signal and pin on the right. Take it easy and have a safe flight.
And if you guys didn't notice, we're flying at night. That's even more dangerous. That's even more dangerous. All right, taxi light is coming on. Okay, I need that on. But I need to turn down these lights over here. It's too bright in here. So, MFD, that's a loudspeaker. How do I turn down these damn lights? That's the ND. Oh, San Francisco ground is on. Shit. Let's see here. 4205. Alright, well, we got ground on, so we gotta go talk to ground. 4205. Yeah, we're going in the nighttime and it's in Reno. You guys are freaking screwed. Alright, so that's armed. Seatbelts are on. ATCs, and we already know that. That's good there. Status is normal. Clear. Takeoff config. Auto brakes to max. So that is good there. Cabin to go. Alright, I gotta turn the radio in to 121.8. What is the ATIS here? ATIS is... Oscar. San Francisco ground, United, 1049, ATIS information, Oscar ready to taxi. I gotta call, dude. I gotta be a professional pilot. Oh, you know what? I didn't set up my headset. Hold on. I'm using a different headset. Where is it? Where's the other input? This one.
Hey, just United 1049, San Francisco ground. How do you read?
I got you 5x5 now.
Whereas, if you didn't hear before, runway 1R, taxi to Alpha Alpha 1.
Alpha Alpha 1, runway 1R, United 1094. 1049. Alright, here we go. Brakes should have went off. They're not off yet. This thing sticks. I don't know why. Okay, I gotta really be easy on these turns. Never mind. Faith is restored. Okay, good. See, you know what I didn't fix yet is these damn lights. It's too bright in here. Way too bright. It doesn't really seem like they want to turn down. Floodlights near the transponder. That's the panel light. That one doesn't work. Yeah, it's still too bright. It's not that one. We'll get to the runway. We'll look at it one more time when we get to the runway. This seems too bright in here. Let me see, let me look. I get straight enough here, I'll take a look on the overhead. I turned the overhead one down too. Yeah, I turned the over one. But, oh shit, that's what happens when you don't. See, we can't do that, guys. Gotta wait till we get to the runway. You guys, I'm gonna kill everybody before we get there. Alright, hold on. Wait till we get to the runway. Wait till we get to the runway. Holy crap. I almost took everybody out, or I probably did. That's what happens when you look up and you're trying to taxi. It's gonna be okay, Brian. We didn't hurt anybody, I don't think. We're gonna be fine. We're gonna be fine. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. Uh-oh. She's here now. Nothing is fine. Let me see if I can take a look up real quick. Okay, that's for the overhead. We need that on. The dome light's on. That's what's on. The dome light's on. Where the hell is the dome light? That's what's on. Right over the overhead? Okay. When we get to the runway, we'll look at it. I don't want to go under the ramp again and run over people. Yeah, this passenger. Okay. It's just too dark. Alright. There's no weather, so we don't have to worry about turning the weather radar on. I'm still scared. I'm still scared. I'm flying at night. I should never fly at night. We're going into a mountainous airport.
United 1049, Unicom out of flight.
Over to Unicom, United 1049, see ya. Alright. We'll pull up over here and stop for a second so I can get this light turned out. See, you guys came for comedy hour. You guys came for the comedy hour. Alright, we're gonna hold right here. Brakes. Oh, awesome, my brakes don't work. My brakes don't work. Alright, stand by. Look, my pedals are not working. Alright, hold on. Bloody hell. I have no brakes. I have no brakes. That one works. That one works. Yeah, it works. All right. I gotta wait a minute. Mingo, what's up? I can park anywhere I want, Mingo. Alright, I'm on the runway. Who gives a shit? Nobody cares. Alright, so this one, Let's see. Oh, there it is. I see it. Yeah, that's what it is. Boom. You guys rock. You guys rock. Okay, that one works there like that. That's good like that. All right. Now that we're on the runway, I look like a dodo. Let's go ahead and turn everything on now. Don't tell anybody that I did this. I'd totally be yelling at a pilot right now. Oh shit. I wonder if I can make a UE on this. I don't know. That's a pretty tight turn. Oh, we can do it. We can do it. You said 122.8. There's nobody here anyways. We're just gonna go. Alright, you guys ready? SRS, blue toga. Auto thrust, blue. Don't be scared. V1, rotate. Positive rate. Gear comes up. Autopilot on. Don't be scared. Freaking Hunter. There's the turn. Doggone Hunter. There's level climb. Okay, let me turn off this light. That's a little bit better, huh? Now the light goes out. Now we get what we wanted. Alright. So now we can go ahead and turn off the taxi light. Now I can't see shit. I can't tell if that's off or not. Yeah, it's off. Oh, look at that. I kept the APU on. Okay, that's on, that's on. That's good, that's good. Now it's hella dark in here. I got it. I flew it last night, but I didn't fly it online. Mr. Brown over Blue, what's up? What's up, Tyler? I'm flying the bus, bro. I'm flying the bus. And X-Plane 12.
Hell yeah!
We're going to Reno. Should we fly this at night, or should we do it daytime so you can see what it looks like in daytime? You guys tell me. Okay, so Hunter says daytime. Whatever, bro. Whatever, Troy. I think it looks better at night. Okay, night. Okay, daytime sounds like a bright idea. So, all right. Everybody's scared. So that's what we're gonna do. You know what? How about dusk? How about we do it in dusk? Let's do it in dusk. We'll do it in dusk. So we still have a little bit of light. So let's call it right there. Wait, let's let it load. There, we call it. Now I can't see shit. I gotta turn all these up. Alright. The lighting still sucks in the sim. No, I don't know what you're talking about. Flaps are up. What are you talking about? Why is this one dark? Now I can't see this one. That's not this one, right? I can't see that one. That's got to be down here. There we go. There we go. Now I can see. What? The flaps are up. What? What's wrong? What? Look at all that beautifulness down there. No landing gear is up. You guys are crazy. I can turn this one off though. Where is it? Wing light. Beacon stays on, that stays on. Turn off turns off. And then we can turn those off. Don't be scared. The altimeter is not at 18,000 feet yet. 3021. That's the altimeter in San Fran. God, you guys are so judgmental. So judgmental. What? Oh, that? Nobody needs oxygen. Oxygen's overrated, bro. Alright, 17 left. I like how it's taken the weather already. Landing condition full, air conditioning's on, pilot, brake mode will be, well, I'm flying it. We're gonna go medium. Reverser's on. Required landing distance 5648. Predicted landing distance 6148. Great for approach 132. Hey, Tyler, did you update the TOLUS? Yes. You get a drink, and you get a slap on the back for saying thanks for flying. Oh, we're gonna crash. You ain't gotta worry about it. It's gonna happen. The lighting in here still sucks, though. Not a fan of the lighting. See, it should look like this. It should look like this. That still says primary. What is it? Not that one. It is... that one. I've been updating so many things. I need to update. Yeah, the 319, the 321. That's why we got the ATC data link on standby. Because now we have CPDLC. But it's still too freaking dark. Even with that on, the panel's still dark. Yeah, Josh. This is X-Plane 12. All right, there we go. Now we go standard. Yeah, they updated the A340 as well. They added CPDLC to that thing too. Yeah, I'm using what is it? V-States Ortho. So everything works with it. You know what? I don't like the lighting. Sorry guys, I'm changing it again. The lighting sucks. That's one thing people have been complaining about, is the lighting. It looks ugly. Uh-oh. No Phoenix on this one. See how it's bright outside and it's still dark in here? I don't get it. I don't understand it. You want to fly the Challenger? I just updated the Challenger too. I just updated that too. Yeah, you can't make fun of the X-Plane Sim because it's number one in somebody's heart here. X-Plane is number one sim in somebody's heart. I won't say who. But yeah, see, it should look like that right there. That's what it should look like. I have all three. Yep, me too. Musfus, P3D, and X-Plane 12. I don't have 11 anymore. I took 11 out. Yeah, exactly. He might not be here anymore. I don't know if he's here anymore. I know he's got to get ready to go to the airport. So freaking bright. This time of day is bright too. He's probably commuting already. Yeah, I think he is. He was flying down to Vegas. Oh wait, no. You know what? He's in Vegas. Cause I think he gets into Vegas at 9, and then he's got to wait till like midnight, I think, or something like that. Yeah, but Mingo, nobody's really mentioned P3D version 6 yet, really. Technically. Okay, 24 for 29, we're almost there. Look, we're gonna get to 29 and then we gotta go right back down again. Three hours to go to the slots, get food. Yep, you can go in there and gamble for a little bit. We're just gonna keep the seatbelt signs on, obviously. Not yet. It hasn't been confirmed yet. Has not been confirmed yet. Oh, that's the wrong one. I wanted to try out the CPDLC, but not many people here in the States uses it. Let's see. That's a speaker. I don't care about that. That's the ones I want to turn up. Okay, we're at 27. Then we're going to have to go right back down again. The stupid thing up here is not working. The fly live thing. It is so bright out there, though. No, they were talking about some kind of engine that might be coming. I read a little bit more deep into it. I don't think they're going to bring that. There's some kind of special engine that they were going to use. For the graphics and whatnot, but it hadn't been confirmed yet. What the hell does that mean? Yeah, I think that's what it was called. Remote server return to code. I don't even know what the hell that means. Hey, look, I got an ETP. Alright, we gotta bring this down to 16 now. Hey, this information Delta. There's an RNAV approaches and use landing runways 17 left. Notice the airman runway 17 right is closed. Happy holidays. I'm scared. It's so bright. It's killing me. I don't know what they're doing because they just changed it. You know, they just changed the runways there. So I have no idea what the hell they're doing. Like, yeah, I know. I'm going to put it in there. Don't worry about it. I'm going to do it here in just a second. Aegis City, 10 miles, 170. That's going to be... where is it at? Performance. Cruise. No, next page. Next phase. See, I haven't flown this thing in a long time. Alright, QNH is 3020. Temperature 03. And the wind is 170 at 5. No. Decision height. Decision altitude. I'm thinking 339 on that. I'm thinking 339. I could be wrong. I could be wrong. You approach 131. All you guys should be scared. I want to take, it's so damn bright. What's a good time where it's not so bright? Like right there? I've been wrong once before. It's still too bright. I've been wrong once before, but I was mistaken. I was mistaken. Oh, look who it is. What is going on, Mr. CJ3? What's going on, Derek? Thanks, brother. We in the CJ3 yet? Oh, yeah, of course. Don't you know? PM? No, 3 PM would still be too, it would be too bright. I wanted to, like, let's try that. Yeah, just finished my check ride. Oh, there we go. That might be better. Not much. So when you start flying, dude, when's that first trip? January 7th. Hell yeah, good song. Yeah, it's just weird. It's too bright outside. And I don't like the lighting. It's just too damn bright. The bus can't fly 0.2 from what I know. You'd be limited RP 107 in case you set the barometer 5,000. Minimums to 5,000. Alright, let me go back here. So 5,000. So you're saying RMP 017? Alright, so let me go back to it. So I should do the minimum decision altitude of, 5,017. Progress page. L7. Which one is that one? Down here? boom. And then go back to bloody hell. Was it performance? Next. 5017. There. Can you confirm that, Captain Tyler? Can you please confirm that for me, please? Okay. We're good. If Captain Tyler says we're good, then we're good. All right. We're good. That is completely noted. Shit. This lighting is freaking terrible. I don't care about that. I'm gonna turn this one down now too. See, this is the way it should look. If I'm looking at it, it should look like this. I'm whining like a little bitch. That's okay though. This lighting's pissing me off. That's what I'm saying. I don't know. This is their lighting.
Stop whining.
Whatever, bro. Well, you know what? So I don't forget. Because I know I will forget if I don't do that. We're gonna do medium because I suck. I don't know, Josh. It just seems super, super bright. You know what? Can we go in there? Let's see. Graphics. I don't think that'll have anything to do with it. I don't see anything would have to do with that, D. I don't think I see anything that would change the lighting. But as you get closer to it, this is what it should look like if I'm back more. It should be like this right here. But it seems like the farther way back you are, the darker it is. Let me just turn this down. Yeah, it's weird. It's very, very weird. All right, we're almost at Hoboa. So Hoboa is at 16, Senda is 11, and let's see, Hogbo is at 6,900. So Captain Tyler, may I set the altitude to 6,900? And it should follow that altitude all the way down. Is that correct, sir? Oh, you're not supposed to do that? Oh, you know what it could be? You know what it could be? Window reflections. I don't think, that didn't do much. Maybe a little bit. Yes, everything connected. You should be able to hit approach once it's clear. Okay. I forgot I'm still on his frequency. Clear for the RNAV Zulu runway 17 left approach. United 1049. Okay, 3012. Oh, is it 3020 is the altimeter? United. Now, see, it's a little bit better now. I think it had to do with that, the settings. Yeah, you better grab your popcorn because it's going to get interesting. The shit's about to hit the fan. It's about to hit the fan. Okay, here comes our level off. Right before Hoboa. Four minutes. Yeah, lighting's a little bit better now that I turned all that stuff down. What is it? 5, 6, 4. I'll turn this down a little bit. That's all. It would go bright. No, we don't want that on. You guys should be super scared right about now. Okay, come on. There we are. We're at Hoboa. It's slowing to meet the 210. Yeah, you're scared. I'm scared. Don't be scared. Everybody, it's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. What's the worst that could happen? What's the worst that can happen? I mean, come on, really. What's the worst? What's the worst? I think we're gonna be just fine. Yeah, we're about to find out. Let me make sure I started Volanta. I did, okay. I mean, there's a possibility, yes, we could crash. There's always that possibility. Oh, Quasi, that's hurtful. That's hurtful. I'm gonna be fine though. I'll be fine. Strobes are on auto. That doesn't come on yet. We'll turn the wing light on. So hurtful. The clouds are a little bit better. They're not great, but they're a little bit better. That's right, Hunter. Send him a 22.8. I don't need that negativity here. I got Captain Tyler. Captain Tyler is directing me. So tomorrow we got up to what was it? $899 for the charity event. So tomorrow I'm just gonna go down and hand him a check for that. So thanks to everybody that donated. Greatly appreciate you guys. As always, you guys are awesome, and we're gonna go down and give that check to him tomorrow while I'm out running some errands. So I will go to get a what did we get last time? Did we get a money order or was a cash? I think it was a cashier's check, and that way I can sign it over to him. So much love, man. Much love. Oh, you know what? We probably should go back inside. What the hell am I doing here? All right, Captain Tyler, I think we're looking good, man. We're looking good. I think we're going to be just fine. Speed's at 210. It's perfect. You think we're high? Yeah, we're a little high, aren't we? Should we hoist? I thought you meant hit the approach button. Miles, thanks, brother. Appreciate that. Damn it, Captain Tyler. I can't even see the damn approach button. There it is. Can we? Does it matter? Will it be okay now? We should be okay now still, right? Thank you, Miles. Appreciate it, brother. Damn, you know what that looks like? A damn freaking mountain we're going into. What the frick? Doesn't it look like... What the hell is that? That's a cloud? Alrighty then. We're about 1,000 feet high. That didn't look right. Moments before disaster. All right, Tyler. When should I go? When should I go? Flaps one. Tonight. That's so messed up. Now? Okay. Flaps one now. We're on the RNAV. We're doing it. We're a little high. We'll get her down. Here comes the turn. Tyler let me fly. You should be scared. You should be very scared. At least it's flying the RNAV pretty good. We're still a little high. Hurtful, man, hurtful. Alright, Tyler, I'm thinking another notch of flaps coming in here. Your thoughts? Okay. Flaps 2. And gear's going down. Don't see the airport yet. We're still a little high. There it is right there. I think that's it. I might have to help it down a little bit here. Yeah, I think we're going to go back to San Fran. What the hell is this? What in the hell? What? That's supposed to be a cloud? Come on, X-Plane, that's terrible. That's freaking terrible. You know what? I think we're going to be able to do it. And I think I'm going to go ahead and go flaps 3. If you concur, Mr. Captain Tyler. This is a nice approach coming in like this. I mean, it's following it down really well. I mean, I guess I should have called on Unicom, but I didn't call. I haven't switched the radio, so don't anybody tell on me. Don't tell on me. I'm gonna go flaps full. We're gonna have to help it down. It wants to, what are you doing? Come on, autopilot off. Why is it? I didn't turn off my auto throttle. We're gonna have to go around, I bet. I didn't even touch my auto throttle. I hit the disconnect for the autopilot. We're gonna be too high. Try to do some S turns. Come on, get down. Alright, you guys better hold on to your asses. We're not going around. We're not going around. We're sending it. We don't have time and fuel to go around.
Sink rate. Minimum.
Oh yeah. We're gonna die. Shut the hell up. Nope. This is the way United would really do it. Oh, it's not gonna go down? Come on.
10, 5.
Get down. We got it. We got it. I don't know what you guys are scared about. We totally got this. Look at that. Come on, guys. Why are you guys all scared? Nothing to be scared about. We made it. You guys are all scared. Plenty of runway to work with. Plenty of runway to work with. Look at the, even the fans on. I gotta fix the steering on this thing. Holy shit. My brakes not working again? Brakes not working again. I have no brakes. Awesome. No brakes. It's like the, what do they do? What's it called? It's not calibrating them. All right. That was a lot of fun. You guys got all scared and shit. There was no reason to be scared. We totally made it down, guys. 230 feet per minute. 230 feet, 1.8 G's. Kind of, you know, kind of a hard landing, but 230, man. All right. You get, okay. 230 feet a minute. I'll take it. Wasn't that bad. Let's see, where was my touchdown mark? My touchdown mark was halfway down the runway. It was halfway down the runway. We're totally fine. I don't know why you guys were all scared. What? Somebody talking to me? I landed in the landing zone on the other side of the runway today. You know what, bro? Whatever, bro. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. I feel like I'm being judged. I'm gonna cry like a little bitch. Yeah, I'm too cool for the touchdown zone, man. I need a challenge, bro. I need a challenge. Touchdown zones are overrated. Yeah. Touchdown zones are overrated. Totally overrated. What did I see? I was going to C5. I got no brakes. Why aren't the brakes working? All right, hold on. I gotta figure this out. Right toe brake. Right. And then yaw. I'm going faster than I was going before. We're gonna go off the runway. I mean the taxiway. Now my brakes work. Alright, now they work. We're good. Be right back. Gonna get a bottle of whiskey. I need one after. Whatever, Milo. Words are hurtful. Now I can't move. What happened? Hello? The frick's going on? Now I can't move. Brake is off. Now my throttles don't work. Alright. There, now they're back. But the question is, they're back, do I have pedals? And I don't have brakes again. Bloody hell. I gotta have to set up a profile for the Airbus, which I thought I had, but I guess I don't. But now I don't have brakes again. Where the hell is C5? It's gotta be this terminal over here. Yeah, they should. You freaking are right, they should. Sons of, I'm just gonna park it in again. I don't know where the hell C5 is at. I'm gonna park it the closest and easiest one. Oh, I'm gonna have to, because my brakes are not working. Guess I probably should turn off the taxi light. Help the ramper out, I don't know, maybe. C9, that's good enough, it's an American gate, I don't care. If I ruined anybody's immersion, not my problem. Come on. brakes are not going to work. Feels good to be a gangster. It ain't easy being a gangster. Half a bottle down. Come on now, Miles. It's not that bad, bro. Hey, you should be proud of me, Miles. This is the first time in a long time that I've flown an Airbus. No, no brakes. This is irritating. No brakes. And I have an Airbus profile, but it's not staying to it. I don't need to take this. They still don't work. Alright, we're not gonna fly this again. This is pissing me off. My brakes are not working. I gotta figure out what the hell's going on. We're all just gonna die. I guess I could have put on my parking brake. Do you have something else assigned to the brakes? I don't think so. Let me see. Pitch roll, nose tiller. Flaps down. Flaps. Nope. Says multiple axes is assigned to yaw, left toe brake, or right toe brake. Well, which one is it? I don't see them on here. Throttle pitch stick. Let's make sure again. Let me look through on this really quick. Landing gear toggle, no. Side twist, no. Okay, nothing there, so maybe, let's see, is it the throttle? Throttle 1 and 2, auto throttle, engine starter, bank. Yeah, it won't say. Flaps, throttle 1, speed. Those are speed brakes. Wait. No, that's truck lift and landing gear. Auto brake 1, auto brake 2. Right toe brake. Here it is right here. We need to get rid of these. What's your problem? Oh, she's dreaming. Those are not my pedals though. That's the weird thing. I don't have those pedals. None, none, and none. Maybe that's it? Let me see. Clear Kai, what's up, bro? Let's see. Let me do the map thing really quick. Let me see if I can back this up and pull it into the gate again. Let's see if it fixed it. All right. Stop. There we go. That's what it was, Tyler. That's what it was. God, you're so smart, dude. It's almost like you know what you're doing. It's crazy. Now we're coming in hot. Stop. Look at that. Brakes work. Hell yeah. We got brakes once again. Alright, we can re-flight plan now back over to San Francisco. Not straighten it, straighten it, straighten it, straighten it, straighten it, straighten it. Come on. Come on. Now I gotta work on the tiller. We'll do that later. You want me to fly the max? You wanna do the max? We'll just make up a flight number out of here. You want to do the max? We'll do the max. You want to do the max? All right, we'll do the max. We'll do the max. It's going to take forever to load, and the gates are probably not going to work. But that's fine. We'll fly it out of here. We'll go back to San Francisco. So, with that case, I got to get rid of this stuff. So, hold on. Let me put away my... I gotta get rid of my Airbus stuff. I gotta set up for the Boeing. The Boeing! The Boeing! Did I already do it? Yep. Remember to put all that shit away. Alright. We'll leave that. We'll get rid of this. Alright, this is gonna take a while to load. It's not very fast because it's got a lot of scenery to load. So we'll go from Reno back to San Francisco like I did last night. I'm just gonna make up a flight number here. It'll be a repo flight. So we'll come up here, we'll flight plan for it, sim brief. Oh, Aeroflyer. No, we're not doing United 6969. We're just gonna do United 2507. Oops, I put it in the right spot. That's what they usually do reposition flights with. We'll do Reno, KSFO. This is totally, totally not realistic. We'll use San Jose. They don't fly the max out of here, but that's okay. 535, that'll work. Do I have one in here? I do. I'll use the Southwest one, but we'll change it. Fly lifestyle, that's whatever. What United plane do I have in here?
Stop whining.
I'm trying to. Let me see. United 27261. That's not gonna matter though. I can change it when I file it. 17 left, 28 left, that works. No, we don't need that much fuel. 500 pounds. 280. No passengers. We need some ballast. So, what do you think? Ballast, 6,000 pounds? That works. Zephyr 7, Merlet, legs, Bodega 3. Altitude, that looks good. Zero packs, tight time. Alright, I'm gonna go with that. You guys agree? Alright, good. I agree too. Okay, there's that. We'll go file it. And this is where we're gonna change it. 27. What I say it was? Shit. Now I forget. You guys made me forget. Doggone you guys. It's all your fault. 27261? I think it was 251. Where is it here? Yeah, it's 27251. Aeroflyer, you're fired. I don't care about any of that. That's good there. That's the wrong origin when it comes from. We'll go ahead and fire. We're gonna have to fire Aeroflyer. Okay, that's filed. That's done there. We can drop that. We come in here and we can configure this here. So it's, they do have 166. We're gonna go empty cargo. What do we got for cargo? 4198, that's too much. We want less than that. 40%. 73, I said 6,000. So it needs to go down more. That's good enough. Fuel, I didn't see what the fuel was. But that's okay, we'll get this loaded here. Where is that? These two right here. You lost it by one number, bro. Alright, we're gonna keep it. It's gonna be... We wanna go nighttime? Nighttime sucks, though. I can't fly worth a shit during night. Dusk? We'll go dusk. There is one. You're right. There is one. There is one. You're still fired though. You picked the wrong one. Okay. All right. Now we're gonna start a new flight. And what? Jack, there you go. I thought I filed that. Didn't I file that? Oh, this freaking piece of crap. Volanta. No. Shut down. Volanta. Quit. Restart. Plan a new flight. Add a flight plan. Load it from SimBrief. There we go. Now we gotta wait. Now we gotta play the waiting game for this thing to load up. What's doing that? We'll load up Fly Live because it crashed on me. Settings, chatbot, overlay. Get that there, a dashboard, Reno, San Francisco, United 2507. I should do that. I should come up here to that, like that. There we go. Now we gotta wait for the sumbitch to load. This is what takes forever. And I don't have P3D on a SSD. So it takes a little bit longer to load. I've got it on a 5 terabyte. Well, it's a hard drive, but the hard drive is only this big. So it's a small hard drive. It'll load up in a minute. It's just got to load all the scenery, all the ortho and everything from Orbix. Has iFly planned their max version? Not yet. They haven't said anything yet. I hope they do. Because I don't know if you heard, but Congress has given Boeing the green light to go ahead with the MAX 7 and the MAX 10. So we should be seeing those here pretty soon. They're going to be flying. Congress gave the AOK. I think the MAXes that are out there already, the airlines have to add, I don't know, some program to it. I don't remember what they called it. But it's like a software update that they have to add to it, and the new ones have to have it too. Oh, nice. Yeah, United's got a whole bunch of them. Boeing's been flying the United Dash 10 already, test flying it. It's up and flying. And I think they announced this, I think it was announced yesterday, that Congress gave the green light. Can you imagine if Congress said no? That would have been it for Boeing. Yeah, and United added, they bought more 787s, yep. If Congress would have said no, that would have been it. That would have killed Boeing. Because imagine all those 737 MAXs they have sitting that are already built, they just couldn't deliver them. That would have killed Boeing big time. Boeing? And then that other company called it Scarebus, but Airbus? Pairbus? Sparebus? No, Airbus. That's what it is.
Denied.
Oh, Miles. It'll be okay. But United did order the A321s, the Neos. Those are supposed to be coming next year. But now that they said that they've ordered the 787s, additional 100 787s, that they might not take delivery of the A350s now. Oh, that's messed up. When they took over McDonnell Douglas. Yeah. Oh, this is what takes so long. It's gotta load up Orbix and everything else. I should have put it on an SSD. Oh, it would have been a huge hit for them. It would have been a huge hit. Yeah, so now that they're saying that they went to Boeing and that they've taken those additional orders of the 787, they might rethink the A350 now. This Quality Wing 7, yeah, we haven't even heard about the Quality Wing 787 even being brought into MusBus yet. It is, I mean, I've got a lot of scenery in there. I got some ortho from other states in there too, so it's going to take a while. I told you. It probably takes about a good 5 minutes to load all this. Well, I can't show you the scenery, but they can't keep up with the delivery schedules anymore. Not to forget, Boeing has a huge military footprint. This deck's full of jets, helicopters, and bridges, military over there. Oh, yeah. Yeah. One of these days. So I'm going to take that 2:30 landing in Reno. Coming in high and hot. Yeah, it's true. They do take the perfect aircraft. Do it takes a while to load perfect aircraft. All right, time to get serious now that we're gonna fly a Boeing. It's time to get serious. We're serious now. Boeing makes the Apache. Oh my god, did this thing put me on the runway? It put me on the runway. Alright, that's fine. We're just gonna start up on the runway. I'm not gonna load it up on the ramp. What's going on with this? What's going on with my stream here? PatBra94, thanks for the follow. You see this? Why is it doing that? It's like I'm missing part of the screen. Hold on real quick here. Display capture. What the hell is that? Brown over blue, thank you, sir. Thank you for the 500 biddies. But I'm missing like half the stream. Let's see, display capture. It's, what is it? It's not, is it webcam? No, that's that. Web overlay, no. Flight sim? It's like not showing the whole thing. Are you guys seeing the whole thing? So you guys are seeing the whole thing. Okay, maybe it's just on my side. It looks weird. All right. Let's get it started here. So we're just gonna start it from the runway, because if I do it at the gate, it's gonna take us forever again. And ain't nobody got all day. All right, let's get that on. We'll get that on. And we'll go ahead and go to number 3. That's taxi light, dipshit. What is it? 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn on some lights in here. You do have all day? Okay. All right. Well, I unfortunately do not.
I have to do some honeydews.
All right, well, that's getting up. I need to load up the Boeing yoke and throttle while we're waiting. I got to get this all set up again. And get this beast set up on the desk again. Wish I could just leave it on the desk, but I can't. Because then it takes up my room when I want to control. And it's in the way. So let me, right there like that. All right, we've got APU power. We got APU power. That can come on. That can come on. Set to 28,000, 50 feet in San Francisco. I'll turn on the window heat now. Those can stay off for now. Okay. Let me get everything hooked up here. Like that. Alright, let's go. Let's see. I gotta remember what buttons I have here. Set that to align. Not that. Wrong one again. This one. Wait, that's bright. That's too bright. It's that one. Alright, we get that. Let's go down the FMS. Or bring it up here like this. Position. This is what I like, the keyboard. Reno. Put that in there like so. Come over to the root. San Francisco. United 25. Oh, shit. Okay, so that's where it's going to have a trouble. It's my keys. All right, I got to fix that. 2507. Runway 1. We're on runway 17 right. We're just going to stay on runway 17 right. I know it's going to kill your immersion. You guys will be fine. I just don't want to have to load this damn thing all over again. Oops, wrong thing. Erase. Actually, should be Zephyr 7. You know what? Wait a minute. No, I guess it's got the right stuff in there. Merlette. Zephyr 7, Merlette, legs. And then from there. Oh, here goes the CB dev. This is unacceptable amounts of immersion. Mingo, 122.8. 22.8, my friend. We're going to take it from side by. Okay, we got the fuel that we want in the 13.6. So that's fine. Come over here. We got a discontinuity. Brah. We'll put that there. And from here, zero fuel weight. Let's turn the power here. Bruh. Initialize flight. Performance. Let's go to weight and balance. Read from the aircraft data. That's what's got it in there. The taxi out fuel. Where's my flight plan? Flight briefing. Taxi out fuel is 500. Damn it. 500. The planned trip fuel is. Damn, I'm barely burning anything. 3825. We can complete that. Copy data from FMC. It's dry. It's already taken into account. You know what I didn't start? Let me start Active Sky really quick. BW, you should fly the Apache me with DSS. I should show you around. You and that Apache, I tell you what. I'm going to buy you Apache for Christmas. You want an Apache for Christmas? I'm going to buy you one for Christmas. I'm going to get you one. Alright, I won't be able to see your comments for a minute. So, conditions here in Reno. Oh, you know what we didn't do yet? Hold on, guys. It's not even raining. I don't know why it's doing that. I need to download. What am I looking for? Sembrief. The winds. I need the winds. So let me go in here. P3D. Downloaded it. Now I can get rid of that. Alright, let me go find it in the flight plan. Load. San Francisco, Reno to San Francisco. Okay, it's not going to be in there. It's going to be in documents. No, back it up, Dodo. Files. Reno, San Francisco. Boom. Hey, money. Money is just a number, my friend. Money is just a number. Okay, there was nobody here. So we're a low V pilot. There was nobody here earlier. So I gotta let it. Looking for models. Wonder if anyone has ever flipped off the IRS while taxing. Hope not. That would suck. Okay, United 2507. I hope there's nobody here. You already got the weather for me. Thanks, Tyler. You know what? We're going to disconnect for a minute. There we go. This is better. So, ATIS is Echo. Winds 130 at 4. 130 diagonal 04. Outside air temperature is a whopping 03 degrees Celsius. Q QNH is, where is it? 3021. We'll do a derated takeoff one. Flap config. Runway 17, I'm gonna go with 5. AC on, anti-ice off. Dry, calculate 17 right. So flaps 5 with assumed a temperature. So we got 5,000 of reserve. Cost index of 35. Altitude is 280. And then, wait for it here. And then we're gonna go here. I'll come back to that. I know, what are you doing, B-Dub? It's gonna be just fine. Takeoff 1, 79.7, that's, what if we go here? That's close enough. I don't know how much we're gonna get any closer than that. Yesterday was almost right on it. So 114, 115, and 130. Then if we go to legs, data, request the wind. Yeah, the EFB, I think it's better than the, I think it's better than PMDGs. I thought I did the position already. I'll have to go back and look to see what happened. Okay, the winds are in there. So we got the winds in there. Let's go back to it. It doesn't. Enter IRS position. I don't see why it's doing that. It's already in there. Cruise wind. If I put the cruise wind in there, it deletes the other winds, though. I don't want to do that. If I put them in there, it deletes the other winds. Alright, so why has it not aligned yet? I gotta remember what I did. It looks like it's aligned. It says 7 minutes. What the frick? Position. Why is it taking so long? Well, it has, I think what Mingo's saying, it has one in P3D, and this one's a lot better in P3D. The one that's in P3D. I got everything right. I don't know what's going on here. Seems like everything is right. Okay, it's counting down 6. Now it's working. So all we gotta do is wait for the IRS's to line up and then we can start up. Let's go ahead and we'll do the radios really quick here. We'll turn on the panel here. We'll deny people in here entry. Oh wait, I gotta wait till they align. It won't work until they align. 122.8. Real excited for this plane, might get this week, looks amazing. Yeah, it's freaking awesome. We just need the IRS's aligned so we can get the hell out of here. We'll set this for 28. 28, runway heading is, let's see, oh wait, I'm on 3-4. Oh shit, that's why it didn't do it. Now I know why. It didn't, I thought I set myself on 1.7. That's why it didn't like that. You guys are killing me. You're killing me. You're killing me, Smalls.
Bruh.
You're killing me.
Bruh.
Okay, so it's gonna be the P-Vine. Cards. That's why it said that. P-Vine cards. Let's make sure it's got the right runway this time. 3-5 left. P-Vine cards. P-Vine bard cards legs. Alright. Don't judge me. Runway not available, but that, this is 3-3, this is, wait, oh my god, you know what, guys? You know where we're at? We're in freaking Texas. Oh my god.
Denied.
It put me in Texas. It put me at Randolph Air Force Base. That's why nothing was working or nothing was lining up. All this time I thought I was in Reno. Well, actually we can go to runway 17 left now. Shit. All this time. Son of a bitch. Sorry, guys. That's embarrassing. I thought I was already in Reno. Miles didn't tell me. Freaking Captain Tyler didn't tell me I was at the wrong airport. Nobody helped me. We're going to depart from way 17 left. We're going to do it the right way. So I got to go back and change it again. I blame Miles, too. That's why I need a co-pilot here to say, hey, B-Dub, you're at the wrong freaking airport, bro. I swear to God, I thought it had put me at Reno because that's what I requested was Reno. And I thought that's what it did. Freaking Dodo. You blame Aeroflyer? Yeah, it could. I'd blame him too. You know what? I might even. I'm gonna blame Quasi too. She should have known. Silence is golden. Now we gotta wait. At least it won't take this long, like it did last time. But holy crap, man! I was already expecting to be airborne, ready to go. Now we gotta wait for the IRS's to align. Or maybe I'll put them on instant so we won't have to wait. But now I'm going to see if my route's still there. I don't know if the route's still going to be there. I might have to reload all that crap. Bloody hell. Well, I did this flight last night on the test flight, and I think if I remember the flight time on this is like 40 minutes, 45 minutes or something like that.
Stop whining.
You stop whining. I know. I don't know. Oh, you know why? Because I don't have it set at the right time. I was going to set it at dusk. So it's not even really set for the right time. Bloody hell. She'll be alright. She'll be alright. Yeah, we'll still blame Aeroflyer. Well, see, you come here, you get entertainment, man. What more can you ask for? You get entertainment. She left the room. Nice. Oh, come on. Load up. I was so ready to depart. Now we gotta change it. We gotta change it. The FMC again to show runway 17 left, and the Zephyr departure. Man, I do not want to put this on an SSD. Can you imagine all that having to... Too bad it wasn't easy to transfer over to an SSD. We'll just wait till version 6 comes out. I'm not going to do anything until that comes out. It is. That's why it's taken forever. It's because I have all the True Earth from Orbix in here. Then I have the Orbix Global... Orbix airports, other add-on airports, a couple, I got Colorado and Utah ortho, so it takes a while for this crap to load. Yeah, I mean, that's true, it might not. I mean, what if Lockheed says, you know what, we're done with the public, we're just going to keep it for the military, because that's where our money's at anyways. They could say that. Alright, welcome to Reno, everybody. We gotta do this again. So, departure is gonna be 17 left, because we're at 17 left right now. It's gonna be the Zephyr 6 Merlette again. Why is it still saying that? Reno, San Francisco, 17 left. Why is it still saying that? 3 minutes. Runway not available for that, but that's what the Zephyr 6 is for. Select. Yes, I updated him. But it's still giving me. It's still giving me. I have no idea why it's saying that. Yeah, I'm gonna wait. We got 2 minutes. Wait, did it start with the engines on? No, okay, good. Payload should be right. Let's see. Oh. Now that's gone. Limit and one. That's still correct. Flaps 5. Those are still correct. I think we're still good, Milo. Yeah, the lighting on here is freaking amazing. There we go. All right. We've got the IRS, airport, data, terrain, traffic. Same thing over here. Station, airport, data, terrain, traffic. FMC message. Verify. Okay, it wants me to verify position again. So we'll go back up here again. I don't know why, because we are. Why does it want me to verify? What the is going on? I can't verify because I can't put it anywhere.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
GPS-1. Yeah, see, I can't move that there. Why does it want me to verify position? .9. Yeah, we have full alignment. Flash to Tago. What's going on, man? How you doing? Welcome. Yeah, I mean we got everything lined up. IRSs are aligned. We got that. That's good there. Altitudes are good. So I think we're ready. So we're gonna go ahead and go over here. Turn off the packs. Those are good there. Come back to 3. Start. Spinning up. Thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. It's motoring. At 25%, we'll throw the fuel on. That's what we're supposed to do for the max, is you wait till 25%, then you throw the fuel on. Gotta let it motor, as they say. Hold on.
Hold on.
Sorry, I had to let my daughter in the door here, guys. Oh, look at that. The brake's not set. We're going to roll away. I think I picked a bad night to fly in the KMC. Uh-oh. All right. So we should have a good start here in just a second, and then we'll start that one. There we go. I gotta remember my keys. It's motoring. There it goes. 25%. Fuel comes on. We are looking 4.26 on the trim. Where is it? 8? Yeah, we're about that. Starter valve will be going out. Oops, probably be a good idea to put my fuel pumps on, huh? You guys are not helping me out today at all. What are you guys doing? Come on. Wait a minute. Hold on. Uh-oh. My mouse is locked. How do I get out of my mouse's lock? What in the hell is going on? See how my mouse is locked? There. Okay, we're good. We're back. Alright, 7. I thought we were in trouble. I thought we were in trouble, guys. Guys and gals. Alright, let's go to there like that. Taxi belay lights come on. Flaps we're gonna set to 5. There's 5. We're on 22.8, let's connect. Please don't let there be any ATC on. 3210. Transponder on. Let's look outside really quick. 130. Auto throttle comes on. Flight director. Flight director. On the VNAV doesn't want to come on yet. Look at that. That right there is cute. Just pure sexiness. All right, you guys ready? Let's go. Let's get the hell out of Dodge. Brakes are off. I'm gonna look one more time in the above here, make sure we're all good. See? That comes on. That comes off. We almost left with everything on here. Yaw damps on. This goes to Gen 1. TR1. Comes on. Packs come back on. Auto. Off. Probes. Seatbelt signs. ~50%. Toga. Takeoff config. Flaps are 5. What's wrong with my takeoff config? Flaps are 5. Oh well. We're just gonna send it. I don't know why it's doing that.
V1.
I don't know why it did that. Gear comes up. Speed brake? Ah, it's up. Ah, you know what? You're right. It wasn't up all the way. Good call. Good call. Good call. I just hit the switch. Now, I didn't fly this at night last night. I just flew this during the daytime. Okay, flaps coming up to 1. Flaps want to come up. Taxiway lights can come off. Those can come off. You damn right I should. You should hire me. Freaking A. You imagine me being a Boeing pilot? Hell yeah, dude. I'm just gonna send it. Freaking send it. That's what it's all about. Freaking sending it. Alright, just out of 10,000 feet. Out of 10. These can come off. There's no ATC, so I don't have to worry about talking to anybody. Uh-oh. Hey, Hunter. Hunter, you know what to do. Yeah, I want to go on. I haven't been on a MAX either. My daughter works for... My daughter works for Southwest, and I haven't even flown the MAX yet. It's freaking terrible. Maybe I might do that. Alright, we're not going to hit anything up here, so I'm going to turn off the terrain. There's no weather to worry about. Oh, I'd do it in a heartbeat. This guy gets to fly free. She's been there, what, over a year? And I haven't even used the flying benefits yet. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Okay, we're out of 16, still climbing. I think we're gonna get ourselves a BC B-dub shortcut. What do you guys think? With the B-dub shortcut? I mean, Mingo, you can be a gangster like me. Absolutely. All right, we're gonna get ourselves a shortcut. We're gonna go direct to Lawsit. Why? Because we can. That's why. Direct Lawsit. Okay, we're out of 19,000 feet, standard altimeter. And standard altimeter. That's right, I make the rules. Why are we descending? You guys see that? Why are we descending? We should be climbing and not descending. Alright, something happened. We're not even there yet. In order for that to do that, so let's go here. Cruise altitude. What the hell? Well, that's weird. It got rid of it. Look what it's doing. Now, why would it do that? It didn't do that yesterday. I did direct Lawsit, and it kept on climbing. Once 340 at 6 to 340 gust at 23 gust at 31. Oh, you got this. Piece of cake. Yeah, that was weird. I don't know why it did that. Didn't happen to me yesterday. I'm gonna go back to VNAV here in a minute and see what happens. Alright, it's fine. Looks like it's fine again. Look at my climb speed though, 330. We're taking it right to the red. Actually, climb speed should be really about 290 on a 737. 290, 300. I gotta hand it to P3D though. It still looks sexy. There's Lake Tahoe. You can tell the difference between the... This is just a regular P3D ortho, and then this goes in the True Earth ortho. It's darker. Max engines are power. Alright, well, you know what then, Miles? We'll just let it do its thing. Alright, these can come off. Those are off already. Logo can come off, wing can come off. Now we just sit and let it fly. It's a mini 787. Eight. From what I hear, well, Southwest does 18 and below. According to Southwest, it's 18 and below. United, maybe United's different. Maybe United turns them off at 10, but I know Southwest for sure is 18 and below. And they keep them up all the way up to flight level 180. All right, we don't need terrain. So beautiful. Now, what did I do yesterday? I accidentally kicked off, or I hit the go around button. Which one was that one? I think it was on the throttle. I accidentally hit it. Are you going to take yourself on the down? Yeah. No, I'm not going to go down the bay. I'm just going to go take the 140 off the Lozet down the 7, bring it back around. Go on 2-8 left. I do have the Max 8 and Max 9 X-Plane. Hey, Hunter, do you know they're supposed to be updating that? The guy's going to have a release for it in January. He's updating it. He's updating it as we speak. And he's going to make it... He's trying to make it as good as iFlies. He's going to make the screens look like they're supposed to look, not so freaking stretched out. I'm on the Discord, and they're saying January. So he was hoping by Christmas, but I guess he said something about work or something like that got in the way. And so now he's got to do it for. One thing they do gotta fix here that I have a little complaint about, is it's hard to read, and this has to do with the virtual cockpit. The lettering should be an easy fix, but that's the only complaint I have. If you bring it up, you can see it, but when you look down in here, you can't really see what they say. So VNAV, we're in cruise, we're going to do 0.745. Yeah, they need to clear it up. I mean, even here, you can't see the LNAV and VNAV. If you get closer, let's see how it clears up as you get closer. The closer and closer you get to it, the more and more clear it is. So they need to update that. Other than that, I don't have any complaints about the plane. I don't have any complaints about it. I think it's to be honest, I think it's better than PMDG. PMDG, this thing flies an RNAV approach like nobody's business. Had a friend last night when I was controlling, he was flying, what was it, Southwest 8503, and he did the RNAV into runway 17 left into Reno, and he said the thing flew it perfectly, better than PMDG does. So I guess they still can't figure out the how to fly the magenta line on the RNAV. That's what they say. It has to do with the way PMDG programmed it to fly RNAVs. It actually does not fly it right. The RNAVs and the RMPs. You know what? I bet you we can... Let me look at San Fran. I bet you... San Fran doesn't really have great RNAVs. Basically, San Fran's RNAVs are straight in. There's really nothing to them. They're all freaking pretty much straight in. RNAV GPS. Oh, and you can fly a GLS approach. It's got you can turn the GLS frequency. I don't know if you guys saw that or not, but check it out. You go down here to the radio panel, how it's got the VOR, GLS frequency. You can't do that in the PMDG. You can tune in the GLS frequency. Miles Sydney has that. Don't they have the GLS approaches? Did I hear that? I thought I heard a while back that I thought I was going to do tonight. Yeah, what Miles said. They use this for... You can't put anything in MOSFETs as a commercial product. I don't know how they would get away with it. It works perfect. I've never done a GLS approach in the San Francisco. I mean, should we try it? Because I don't think... Really, I mean, the RNAVs are... That's just an RNAV. That's nothing. GLS? Well, that's really nothing either, though. It's pretty much a straight in. 2-8 right, X-ray, they're all pretty much straight ends. Let's see. You know what? We're going to try the GLS. I've never done a GLS approach. So for the channel, for the frequency for that, frequency is 53415. 53415. What? It won't let me put the 5 in there. Five, five, three, four, one. I can't put the 5 in there. What the frick? How do you put the 5 in there? That's the frequency. 53415. Huh. It won't let me put any other number in there. Why is that? Anybody got an idea? How did you put the number in there, Miles? I mean, it's... Oh, wait a minute. No, it should go in there. I was going to say, maybe there's a point missing, but there's no point. Five, three, four, one, five. Huh. Hopefully Milo can figure it out, because I thought that's how you would put it in there. We're getting close to top of descent. Final approach course, San Francisco is 284. Set it twice. It should accept it. Let me try it on this side. Let's see. GLS 53415. Yeah, it won't take the 5. Because that's what I'm putting in there. 53415. That it even says it in here. Oh, wait a minute. What the hell? Never mind, Miles. I'm an idiot. Fucking wrong one. Dumbass. Never mind. Never mind, Miles. I'm looking at the wrong frequency. I was looking for the RNAV. What a freaking dodo. It's 21.
Denied.
Yeah, I know. 21037. Freaking dodo. 21037. What a dodo. Nah, I've never even flown this kind of approach before, so I don't even know what the hell it does. Rest set, yeah, I know, 1-1000. Third bottle of whiskey coming up. You're terrible, Miles. That's hurtful. So, Miles, a GLS approach is the same thing as an ILS, is that correct? We're not going to use the HUD yet until I figure out how to fly it the right way. There's a descent. San Francisco weather. Landing data. 28 left. Conditions are dry. The wind 020 at 6. Temperature is 52 degrees. Altimeter 30. Oh, it's already in there. That's freaking awesome. Flap configuration ratio 30. AC will be on, anti-ice is not needed, auto brakes, we'll go 2, we'll go show en route, reversers are all operative, everything is working except the pilot, so 123 plus 5, 128 final approach, 5300 needed. The CGLS has provided several benefits to operators over the conventional ILS approaches in case of an ILS approach. The signals are often disrupted by the previous aircraft landing or departing. The GLS approach is immune from this interference. The stability in the guidance is enhanced over the ILS. So why don't I wonder why they don't use that? Because we have, I don't know if you know this, Miles, but here in the States we have the 5G interference issue. I don't think any other country has it but us. And sometimes you cannot fly the ILS due to that. The 5G. Yeah, you guys don't have that problem. Alright, so we said 30. What did we say? 123. 30 and 123. Now, this didn't accept it yesterday. It'll say invalid. Oh, it took it. Of course it did. Yesterday it wouldn't take it. Oh, wait, that's in the ILS. Shit, see? I'm messing up. Pop you in the mouth, punk. But wait a minute. We don't have a GLS. So how do you select it? Is it the same thing? It's got to be the same thing. We're just not using 10955. Because it's not an RNAV. It's got to be the same thing. Because they're the same waypoints. Well, I mean, if we crash, it's Miles' fault. We're just going to go with it's Miles' fault. Listen to those engines. Look at those LED lights. Things are bright. And the RNAV X-ray for runway 33. I'll have to check that one up. That one's a fun approach. Or that's probably a hard-ass approach. Let's see. What? Cancel. Let's see what that looks like. Boston. You said 33 left? Holy shit. Look at that approach. Especially if you're coming from the west. That looks like a fun approach. The other ones are just like coming off the ocean or whatnot. Those are just, almost kind of straight in approaches, but the one coming from the west there. Yeah, that one, that looks fun. Oh, we're not paying attention here, guys. 3021. Two one. Ah, damn it. What the hell is it doing now? Why do I have the plus sign? Why are you messing with me? 3021. I was looking at any of those form. It looks like they are hinting the palm tree Christmas. Bill is a new airport. You mean, wait, palm tree? Palm Beach? San Francisco traffic, United 2507s on the Bodega 3. We'll be doing the GLS approach runway 28 left, San Francisco. Charts. GLS. So look at that. So it's gotta be Palm Beach. It's gotta be Palm Beach. It's not Dallas Love. There's San Francisco. We're gonna be on a 140 heavy. And then after Bricks, we can descend to maintain 7,000. After Bricks. Or Honolulu or Caribbean. Yeah, it could be. You know, whatever, Miles. Your words are hurtful.
You hurt my feelings, Miles. Words are hurtful.
Today's deals, LAX Detroit limited for $20, collected 10 each. It's like 40 discount if you buy independently. Man, there's nobody. Sorry, guys. Sorry. What's up? What's that? Oh. All right, we're getting ready to come up to Bricks. Here we go, 7,000. Oops, 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 oops. Frame rates? 20 to 25. San Francisco traffic, United 2507, descending out of 1-1000 for 7,000, heading 140. Yep, this is in P3D. So, obviously, and I'm running True Earth Orbix, it's at night. I'm using Flight Beam San Francisco, so it's taking a little bit of a hit. Anytime you fly at nighttime and in P3D, it takes a big hit. And I'm running Orbix True Earth, Orbix Global, Flight Beam San Francisco. So I got the weather running. I got a lot of stuff running. Yeah, for the new one, yeah, they've been really, really quiet about it. All right, we're gonna keep on going down to 4,000. Why am I picking up speed? All right, I gotta take over the speed. What in the hell is it doing? I need to take over the speed. Okay, we're gonna turn to a 100 heading.
turn it into heading mode. 1800 feet a minute. Throw some speed brake to help me slow down. Hey Miles, with the GLS approaches, it's the same thing. You arm the APP button, right? I'm gonna go a little bit past the side by so I can slow down. San Francisco traffic, United 2507 737 800 will be entering left base, runway 28 left, San Francisco.
I'm just gonna send it to the runway, man.
Did ground? Yeah, there's nobody on. All right, we're gonna start making our turn here. Zero, three, zero. Oops, not that one. All that on, that's on there, that's good there, that's good there. One notch of flaps come in and help me slow down. This is the localizer right here, so we'll go ahead and continue the turn about a 330 heading. 340. We'll go 330. We'll go arm the approach. Well, I guess it's not going to take it yet. Yes, but everything should be on autopilot. That means you don't touch anything. We'll be back ILS approach now. All right, we'll see what happens, Milo. I'm counting on you. There's the Dumbarton Bridge. Oh yeah, I've got them out. The boards are out. The boards are out. Tune disagree? Well, we're not using that though. I don't know if this is gonna work, Milo. Okay, 190. Gears coming down. It's picking up the glide slope. We're getting ready to send intercept the localizer. I'm still a ways out though. 170. This is the San Mateo Bridge. Come on. Turn. I'm not descending. It's not taking it. Shit. It's not turning me. I'm gonna have to hand fly it. It didn't do it. It didn't do it. And I got Well, even if I did, let's see. You gotta be 1800 at the bridge. I mean, it's on the glide slope. On hitting the wrong button. I don't know, maybe it is doing it. Laps 20. Like I'm gonna go through it again.
2500.
San Francisco traffic, you had 2507, 737, 800, just about over the San Mateo Bridge for a 28 left. Catch the glide slope first. Well, I'm gonna bring it down all the way to the runway. Yeah, see, that's the question is, if you go into the FMC and you select the approach, there is no GLS approach. It's just an ILS, an RNAV. It doesn't show a GLS. Laps 30. Still on the glide slope, 4 miles out. I mean, it's flying the glide slope. Localizer first.
1,000.
I'm off. It's all right. I'm on a hand flight here in a second. I'm way off. Where's the runway lights?
Where the frick are the runway lights?
300. Approaching minimum.
Runway lights, hello?
Minimum.
No runway lights.
100.
No runway lights.
50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
No runway lights. Take the next one. I didn't see any runway lights. San Francisco traffic, 925-07, clear runway 28 left. Oh, I buttered that. What do you guys think I got on that? What do you guys think I got? Anybody want to take a guess? I can tell you it's butter. It's probably my best landing I've ever done. Well, not that butter, but one of my best landings I've ever done at night here. 148. 148 with a 1.26 G. I'll take it. I'll take it. Especially for a night landing? Hell yeah, I'll take it. I will definitely take it. With no runway lights, too. I got another friend request up here. Aviator 218, there you go. Huh. It'll park in the back here. You have a mod for the landing lights to make them brighter? I don't know why I didn't have landing light. I mean, I didn't have runway lights. That's the thing I understand. I didn't have any runway lights. Until I touched down. Now I got 30 frames per second. 30, 39. I love this plane. I just gotta figure out the GLS. That's the first time I've ever done a GLS approach. Once I get that figured out, and I think it'll be easier to understand how to fly the damn thing. I think we're just gonna take it right here. GLS activated the runway lights off. Yeah, right? Something happened. Screwed up my runway lights. Rat bastard. Alright, where's that freaking line at? Can't even see the line. There it is. Boom. Welcome to San Fran. If I can figure out right there. Brakes are on.
7. Alright, about that. Alright. 7. Oops. Oh, I did it already. This can come, my collision can come off. Logo can stay on. That goes on. Got my underlay plane. I play them as so I never see. Let's see, what is it? GLS activated runway lights, obviously. What is that line? Oh, the yellow line? That's just to follow in where to park. That's all that is, just to follow it in. I don't know if GSX works here or not. Oh, it does. Look at that. Operate jetway. We're at United. And the jetway should pull out here. See what happens. No jetway at this operate. Of course not. Rat bastard. Oh, well. Well, I hope you guys had fun, man. That was good. Here, I'll show you right here. Look at this bad boy. Standby. Oops. Standby. So, this was the one in Reno. 230. Little bit of G's there on that one. Right? And then we go back to the one that we just did with no runway lights. Look at that approach. No runway lights. More down, halfway down the runway, but we still put it down at 148, 128 knots with 1.26 Gs. That's not bad. Not bad. Huh. Let's see, Hunter's coming in. Let's see if we can see Hunter out there. He's on the 6 mile final, he said. There he is. Let's see. Let's go watch Hunter. Let's watch him land it really quick. Where is it where you can see? I can't remember. You can see new view, air traffic, 420. That's him right there. Honestly, I don't believe that it looks smoother. Well, I appreciate that. I'm still gonna take it. Oh, you know. Oh wait, this is not X-Plane. I was gonna say we can move over to the runway and watch him. What was up with that? That stutter.
I see how it is.
Oh no, we're gonna watch, dude. You better butter this.
Huh.
I can't get it to go full screen. I don't know, that looked pretty good. Look at him ride the... He's riding a willy. That looked pretty good to
yeah,
me.
I did butter. See? Yeah.
Looked good to me. Alright, let's see. Can I close that window now? There he is. That looked good to me. Nice job. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me. I got some stuff I got to do around here, but let's see. Who is there? Anybody streaming right now? We're going to go raid? Let's go check it up. Where is the Twitch? Hi, Hazel. Let's see who we got on right now. We got Joe. Joe's got 62 people watching Joe right now. Oh, yeah. Oh, wait. Stearman Driver's on.
This guy is a real-world Alaska 737 captain. What's he doing?
I imagine, like the G1,
looks like he's flying the DC-3. You guys want to see Joe? Okay, Joe. We'll go to Joe then. We'll go over to Joe. We'll go raid Joe. Joe's doing some late-night ATC. So we'll send it over to Mr. Joseph. Mr. Jersey Aviator here. Let's get it in. Jersey Aviator. Boom. All right, guys. Thanks again. Greatly appreciate it. Thanks for the... thanks, Miles, for bringing this up to a little over... pretty close to 900 now. Or a little over 900. Yeah, over 900 something. I'll have to add it up. I think it's pretty close to 1,000. Right, I think, you know what, we're $51 away from 1,000. So, thanks everybody for, there was a couple follows. There was some tier one that came in, some biddies that came in.
230 via Bravo 51.
Hold on real quick. So, just want to thank everybody for that, and we'll see you guys on the next one. Maybe we'll do some more flying again. This was fun, but maybe we'll do some daytime flying. We'll do some daytime flying next time. But until then, everybody, go over and say hi to Joe. Take care. Stay safe. We'll see you guys later. Peace.
That's right. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.